Boredom, frustration, loneliness, and fear. Those are all things experienced by quarantined people. And those factors can cause mental health issues, including anxiety, depression, self-harm, or even suicide. Sure, this seems a little bit over-exaggerated, right? Not really. During the pandemic, about 4 in 10 adults in the US have reported anxiety or depressive disorder symptoms, a share that has been largely consistent, up from 1 in 10 adults who reported the same issues between January and June of 2019. Well, I would be naive to think that I could change anything regarding this issue, but then it hit me. What if we could use AR to make social interactions with friends easier? Let them meet up online in groups, but they would be able to talk to some of them individually during those calls. Kind of like a real room where they can go up to a corner and talk to them using their phone. This would not solve the root of the problem, which is COVID, but it would make situations way better. Plus, I would also learn a lot about augmented reality, which is super cool. So here's the plan. Have people join a room using their phone, which has a camera, and in best case scenario, also AR sensors to better the experience. Let them walk around in a 3x3 meter square environment, and depending on everybody's position relative to each other, the output volume changes. I mean, that's the plan. Seems pretty easy, right? I've been already seeing solutions like that in the 2D online space, kind of like Zoom, where you can, you know, drag your character along on the 2D map, but not in an interactive 3D way and not augmented in any kind. So I decided to turn this into a 7-day challenge, which was actually one of the very few challenges I kept. So the basics were pretty easy. During the first day, I worked to place objects and use acceleration and motion detectors to calculate an object's position relative to the phone's camera and then display it in front of it. The next thing I had to do was adding physics, because I believe they're pretty cool and are literally the foundation of reality. To create a realistic environment with an interactive feel to it, this was definitely a challenge, as it almost fried my PC multiple times. The problem now is that bodies are still mathematical objects, which do not look human in any way. So yeah, that happened next. Instead, I replaced them with some weird white characters, which may also look really weird right now, but they will be able to be customizable in the future so that users could, you know, customize them, like the bit emojis, for example. The final thing I implemented for this build was getting the camera's position, going around in a room and calculating distances and therefore sound output using XY coordinates relative to each other players. So theoretically speaking, people could now join a room and talk and walk to each other, theoretically. The only object being able to move right now is just me. I did not implement multiplayer functions yet. Also, I did not work on a Firebase backend system that could handle video calls or voice calls. That would still be a pretty important thing for a video call, I guess. I'm pretty happy though with the outcome, as it was the first augmented reality app I built. And honestly, it didn't turn out too bad. I felt like the biggest problem was getting the relative positions and calculating distances. But I also wrote an article for those who are interested in the more technical side of it, and I also linked the GitHub repository below who wants to see the source code. That's it from now. I will definitely continue working on this project and hopefully implement the functions I just told about. And have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.